All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Aces ROG tournament here at Assembly Summer 2014. My name is Semler, with me is Lerpus, and we are about to get into our final match of Group A, the consolidation match to settle who gets second seed and who has to go home, Lerpus. It's that time already. One of these teams gone, done, history.
Well, one of them already is history.
And that's true, that is true.
One team already got knocked out.
We've lost the Swans.
The last game really was their Swan song.
It was. That's it. No more will we ever hear their beautiful song. But we're going to have the group here in just a second, guys, so you guys can take a look at what we're talking about. This is Group A, and so far we have seen PublicLear.se take the first seed, two wins for them, and that's the format so far today, or for this tournament. The group stage is double elimination format. You get two wins in the group, you're through, two losses, and you're done. You're out. It's over. So now we get to see the teams who have survived the gauntlet so far. One win, one loss. And now, who is going to be moving on in this tournament? We can see Menace right here in front of us.
And it's all or nothing for both teams. Winner goes through the playoffs on Saturday. Losers go home.
What I'm really excited, I mean, already there's something to say here between both of these teams, because this was the first match for them. This is a rematch, in fact, between both of these teams. And it went overtime, 16-19 on Dust 2. So I'm really excited to see these guys go at it again. The rematch, this is going to be potentially one of the closest games we have all group stage long, seeing as how the first one was so good already. But they will be playing on Mirage, so we will have a third map of Mirage here. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. I really enjoy Mirage. Do you enjoy Mirage? No, wait, hold on.
I don't have a problem with Mirage.
You don't have a problem with Mirage? You like this Mirage?
I mean, I like the previous one better.
I was waiting for it.
But I don't have a problem with this one. I do think playing Mirage probably favors Menace in the sense that... they're actually a team, and we could tell from the PublicLear game that they're actually pretty well prepared for this map. Mm-hmm. And some of those strats, like the bombsite A smoke attack, as we're actually live here with the pistol round, they actually take some coordination and planning, so I'm not sure if TMVG can pull those off as a pug.
Yeah, that's a good point right there. It's going to come down to a lot of the firework here, or the ability to get kills. I think that's what we're looking for here. For this T side, and already the flank from Blames, he manages to push it through. And this is something that TMVG aren't going to be too aware of. We've seen it, obviously, in the last match where Menace loved to go for these aggressive pushes from underpass. But TMVG are going to have to adapt to that fairly quickly here. They're going to keep losing men like this. And so far in this round, it is going to be the A play here, and it looks like they are managing to get into a position to be able to deal with this. Oscar with a nice little pop flash over. Looking through CT, and that's a setup for Gustus to get a kill. And Oscar's still denying this plant. This is perfect play, man. It's just buying so much time. The T side under pressure, and he even spots a man getting to get right. He's got so much information now as to the layout of the T of the terrorist team.
And surprisingly, Menace don't peek the planter. They just allow the bomb to be planted. That could be a mistake with Saw so low on health, but he still gets a kill. On Aslak, the 2v3 now. Yes, we get the first kill. He's gonna get the second. Shaker also gets a kill. And they actually win that round. It's a 2v4 turnaround for TMVG. Strong start here. In the first half. And like I said, I think that was a mistake by Menace not to allow TMVG to just plant the bomb. There were no smokes. There was almost no cover. But they just didn't plant. And obviously Derek Gustus just misses an easy kill. So that's a big mistake on his part as well. He definitely should have been able to hit that shot.
That was huge, huge. He gets the drop on him as well. We could saw Yesu not reacting in time, really, to turn around. That should have been Gustus's frag there. So we'll see if he can make up for that as this match progresses. It's only the first round, but the pistol, it's an important one going TMVG's way. And we really do think that, I mean, they need all of the advantage they can get. Blaine's making quite a bit of noise here in B apartments, but I don't think that they were able to spot it. Yeah, they did hear him. They were waiting. Skurk, Aslak, both looking back towards the B apps. Not going to let him get out of there in one piece. In the meantime, on A site, Osku is holding fairly close here. So even if smokes and flashes come through, he's not going to be too affected by them. And this is a very good position for him to have with the CZ, and he already puts it to good use. Saw getting a double kill. In fact, Saw coming up big yet again for Menace. And this is huge. They're turning around the second round here. And this is looking excellent.
A quad kill by Saw now.
Again, Saw is the monster for Menace right now. This seems like his match. He's going to try and sneak up and get close, but the Swagmaster is not having any of it. The Swagmaster is still here. 26 HP, but the bomb has been dropped at pit, and there's a man waiting right on top of it. That's Osku, who is going to be looking to see if the Swagmaster is going to take any kind of peek here. Because the Swagmaster, he is actually displaying quite a bit of patience for a master of the swag. I thought that he would just swagger onto this site, maybe go for a plank or two, and then get business done.
He's actually going to save his gun in a 1v2. I think this is a terrible move. I don't see how you would save your gun in a 1v2, no matter how unlikely, against the save round. Questionable move by him. He actually came fairly close if he just jumped out of holes. Obviously, there was no way for him to know it, but if he jumped out there, Menace was playing far enough that he would have actually had a chance. Either way, a sick round by Saw once again.
Yeah.
I mean, just... He's been so good this tournament.
Exactly. Throughout this entire group phase, the matches that we've been able to catch from him have been huge. I believe he was top bragging for Menace in the last game alone, so... This is really big here for Saul. Big opportunity for him to just continue to wrap up frags and actually get his team through this group phase. Second seed. It seems like, again, we're going to have a bit of a position here from Blaine. He's held onto that AK, but he gets overwhelmed at night instantly. Now it's going to be Gustus going for the spray with the FAMAS. They're going to be able to close in on him, however, and this is two great entry kills onto this B site. TMVG, make it happen. There is a quick push coming in from Yesu, but this is not going to be a problem for them. They are not disturbed. Instead, it's going to be the flank coming in from Aslak. He's got the CZ-75. He's going to get in behind them, but he misses his opportunity, and now they know. And they still push him. No fear from Menace. They want a way out. They're not going to let Aslak try and close the door on him.
Nope. And two early kills definitely put TMVG in a very good spot here. Aslak gets a nice CZ-75 shot on Saw there.
And he's still got bullets. He's still got seven. He can do more damage. He's got a teammate rotating in to support him now. That's going to be Shaker, who just goes running around the corner. Burst fire, switches back to single, but he's not going to get it. And in the end, that's going to be two members surviving here for Menace. Two very important rifles held on. But there's not enough money on the team to go for there's not enough money to really go for a big buy here with guns. It just seems like they're going to back it up with some CZs and armor.
Yep. For sure going for this buy here. Nice turnaround there.
This has been really impressive so far. I mean, well, impressive. It's just a back-and-forth game. Big frags, but again, look at Menace. They're going for the underpass push, but Yesu's waiting right here. Is he going to be able to react in time? Osku is waiting right around the corner. Yesu just patiently expecting the push to come from B-Apps, really. And that's, I mean, that's a fairly common thing. B-Apps, maybe the guy gets antsy on that side. He wants to get information as to the T layout, and he starts to push in a little bit, get a little bit greedy. But Yesu... He's in a position to deal with that. The question is he going to be able to react in time? Because Osku's going to come right around the corner, and Osku gets the kill. In the meantime, Aslak, he's going to get the flank. Aslak going for the spray. He's going to get two big kills. Aslak shuts it down. Menace staying way too long, and Swagmaster finds another. This is falling apart now for the defense. It's going to be the man in shadow, and he falls in the darkness. Blaine's the last man alive, 1v4. And so far, Lupus, I mean, this seems to be just very patient play coming out from TMVG and it going their way.
Yeah, I mean, they have some pretty good players for a team like this. Shaker is sort of like an in-game leader type person. He's fairly calm, and he can direct people around. Aslak, obviously, is one of the bigger talents Finland's had. He's just lazy and doesn't really put in enough work to be consistent.
He hasn't
been playing for a couple months now, but I think he's put in a couple hours over the past few weeks. See how he plays, his double kill there. Skurk obviously has a lot of experience playing for Curse and Hawks and Ents, so he's played against top teams before. These other two guys, sort of new, but if they're willing to listen to the other guys, I think this team has a lot of upset potential.
That's true. I mean, we're already seeing them put up a pretty good fight here. Three rounds on the T side. Aslak will find for the first kill. And that's a man being picked off of the B site. So far as they're concerned. I mean, this smoke is down, but Swagmaster, that smoke is about to clear, and he could have a pretty nice opportunity to catch Blaine's off guard. Blaine's is realizing what's going on. In the meantime, we've lost a man in CPL. There is the push coming up from Azlak. He's managed to make his way out from Connector, and Blaine's does manage to stop the push coming in from A-Apps, but it does seem like they are going to manage to wrap around through short onto this B site, and TMVG, they're going to get access without any real problems here. Azlak continues to just... well, rack up frags. He's got four. He's going to get the ace. No, he gets denied at the end. Osiris living with, what, 7 HP. Gets the job done, but that was way too much good work put in by Azlak.
Azlak, obviously, big round for him here. Four kills. Can't really ask for more. Great job. Going to be another round for TMVG. And it's going to be a buy round next for Menace. So we'll actually, at least I think it will. I don't think they're going to save twice, though it is also possible. And good start for TMVG. I mean, Menace really did not seem that strong on their CT side. I didn't think.
But do you think it's the right call right now to save twice? He's not even going to manage to hold on to that gun, unfortunately, there.
Yeah, in that case, I would save twice now, actually.
But nope. They're going to go for it. No fear. Only dreams. And at this point, Menace, they need to just lock it down. TMVG are starting to get some fairly good momentum going their way. They've got good bank as well. 8,000 on Skirk saved up. Two guys with six. This is a lot of money to have. And this is when Menace decided to shake things up. The underpass push, it sort of worked, but it came back to bite them when Azlak caught them. Instead, they decided to go for an upper mid push, which worked out fairly well versus their last opponents.
Yep.
So this could be a big versus Pugliss here, that is. So, I mean, this could be a big opportunity here for Menace to start throwing their weight around on this map. Still trying to see if they actually manage to, open anything up, really. That's the thing. I mean, Osku is still hanging around here at top mid. And TMVG continue to play patiently. They're not willing to push up here until the very end.
Now they are going to be retaking over the middle area. Looks like Osku has actually fallen back. I think Azlak spotted him now, and he's going to fall away. I mean, in a way, that was smart by TMVG not to go there too early and get picked apart. But on the other hand, now they don't have a lot of time to make their next move. And I think it's going to come towards the B bomb site now as Azlak starts to push there together with Shaker.
We're
going to see Gustus here first.
He didn't actually get that smoke off, and now Gustus, good kill there. He could get the second, but he's not going to manage it. Shaker will find him, and then it's just the trade of frags, but Swagmaster missing a golden opportunity to get the one for one. It's not meant to be, doing massive damage, though. He finally gets taken out, and it's going to come down to Yesu now, who's wrapping around looking for the flank. In fact, this guy was over in A Apartments, I believe, and now he's actually worked all the way back, and he's going to come up from short, it seems. But the Triangle of Doom is set up on B side. I almost called you Anders there, but Lurpus.
There's nothing left to be done at this point. Now save your gun, because now there's no way you can win this round. Menace seems to be rotating fairly quickly. You can tell Yesu got a really easy kill coming out of the apartments. So there's probably something there, something to be said for a little B fake and going back towards the A site.
Mm-hmm.
Good round for Menace. They really needed to make sure at least three of their players survived to build some money here going into the future rounds, but still early on, still anyone's game. It's going to be another big round where potentially too much video games could force Menace in a save round.
And again, too much video games. They're really going aggressively to the top of mid. Three people looking at looking to contest here. Osiris actually backing off before the opportunity is there to pick up the frag. And I mean, it's Azlak again. He gets shot immediately, goes for the pop flash, could turn around and actually take this fight. Spots a man getting behind the box. He's going to have to back off here now. This position is starting to get a little bit scary. But that bomb, he actually has to get up here and stop them from seeing that the bomb is dropped here. And he will manage it with the smoke cover. Just shots going actually left and right now. I mean, B Apartments, there's a bit of a firefight going up here. Seems like Azlak mid is the man who's taken the most damage so far for TMVG. Skirk having taken 10. And it does look like they want to end up going for that B site yet again as they are beginning to rotate back through the T spawn. Skirk seems like he's going to be the man playing a bit of the nip move here, trying to draw attention to this A site. We'll see if he can actually manage it by making some noise. The Molly to check the corner. And that's going to draw some attention, but Blaine's catches a man moving around on short. And they spot out the man at top mid as well. I so desperately want Swagmaster to pick up a Swag 7. Because that just seems like that seems just the combo made in heaven right there. Someday we'll get it.
Someday. Speaking of someday, I want to see Azlak offing.
Oh, yeah. If that happens, it could be glorious. Swagmaster goes for the jump, oddly enough, there. And that's not going to help him one bit. And Skirk is now the last man alive here. 4 TMVG, 0, well, not 0 HP or he'd be dead, but 1 HP. He's close enough. Hanging on by a thread. 1v5, it's not meant to be. Menace, at this point, they're not going to even have the time to go out hunting anyway, so they let him live with the gun.
And that is going to be another round in the books for Menace, cutting down their deficit to just one round for now. Still another buy round for TMVG. It just shows how much easier it is to accrue money as a terrorist. You just almost never have to save if you play your cards right and get about a couple bomb plants here and there. TMVG going for a much faster approach this round, already taking over the middle area while the bomb is headed towards the B side. Looks like Gustus is going to see some action here fairly soon.
No, Gustus or Blaine's. I mean, shots going through. It is going to be Gustus, however, getting chased back. Nice nade there from mid to chase him back there. That's 50 damage with the nade. That's about as good as it gets versus Kevlar, so very good pressure. And he just throws that smoke out, and the timing of it just does not work out for him. Swagmaster now going to be peeking out onto the A site. There is a man waiting here, however. Saw the heavy hitter for Team Menace. He manages to not get one, and the team is falling back. This is all over the place right now. They're just peeking forward all across the map, TMVG, and managing to find kills, but Menace still managing to bring it back to a 3-on-3 somehow.
Yep, still a winnable round either way. Aslak is low on health, so that's going to diminish how much effect he can have on this round. Still lots of time to play with. See what these guys choose to do.
I like this position here by Blaine's. Really cheeky little spot he's up here. This could actually catch them off guard. Very early warning if they decide to come through. A little bit of a nade there to slow things down. But TMVG, with 30 seconds left on this clock, are starting to rotate in. That Molly burning valuable time off the clock. But they will make the play now, and there is already a man out on this side. Jesu manages to pick up the first. He's going to get the Molly point blank in the kitchen, which is fitting.
And he's Shaker is going to get the bomb planted. Is he? All screws running out. Shaker's going to stop planning, and now I don't think he's going to have time. That's a catastrophic error on his part. He actually would have been able to get the bomb planted, though obviously there's no way for him to have known that, but...
And Saw
nice retake by Menace there. And Saw once again with a hero's cape
like
there.
Like 9 HP on him and he gets 2 kills? Like he just walks through. He was roasting alive. He took the majority of his damage from that incendiary nade that was chucked in the kitchen.
He definitely has been the MVP for Menace. If Menace make it to the playoffs, it's going to be all thanks to him. And finally, the terrorists are going to be in a save round. Though with CZ75, it's still dangerous.
It is still dangerous, but we have to see if they're going to be able to deal with this. The smokes are down to block things off. They're trying to push through CPL. Bit of a mistake there. Losing 2 members so fast to TMVG and losing the plant as well. Osku will find one. Somehow a man gets behind him, though. And the Swagmaster himself will be able to plant this bomb and get the monies eventually. He should just go for it. It seems like they're trying to wait and see if they can't get another pick. Osiris is here with the AWP and CPL, but that bomb is going to get planted. So at least they guarantee themselves an extra, a bonus.
Oh, that was a nice play by Blaine's. Just waiting patiently enough. Luckily, 2 terrorists lined up. But good play by them. I mean, looked a little dangerous earlier on. And now they're going to get their first lead of the deciding game here.
On the CT side as well. That's the important bit here. Slightly CT favored. Menace are definitely looking to come out ahead here, at least 9-6, at least. They seem to be shaping up for at least having a pretty stable money going into this.
Yep, and now we are going to have a full gun round with an op in Aslak's hands, see what he's able to do with it.
Aslak, I mean, he's waiting, there's a man waiting, this is Osiris up in the A apartments. This is the flash, and there's the kill, 1-for-1 trade, not too shabby actually when it comes down to it. We lose Saw, though, so that may hurt Menace in the long run here.
I'd trade Saw for Duffman. Any point. 4v3 now after Skirt gets a pick, and Aslak still holding on to that op. Round looking pretty good right now for too much video games.
Yeah, this is looking solid. It's all going to come down to Blaine's and his ability to hold on short. They're gathering up here right around the corner, too much video games, as we can see, thanks to the X-Ray. And this is going to be the big moment. They check the corner immediately, and Shaker gets the kill. Shaker gets taken out, but then Yesu, coming out of B apartments, manages to shut him down. And Osiris with the AWP in kitchen is not going to be able to stop this bomb from getting planted. 1v3, highly unlikely that he manages to retake in this sort of situation. They're already set up with the Triangle of Doom, good after plant positions, and they're checking all the angles. He has nothing to shoot at.
Yeah, they're just playing it smart. They're not peeking. There's no reason for them to peek. Osiris is going to probably save this gun, finally running away now. And Menace actually have enough money that it really doesn't matter whether TMVG get these killer kills or not for the next round. It may may matter later on in the half, but not yet. Let's see if Osiris can get a kill here. He does. Takes out Skirk. And he is going to live. It doesn't look like Yes is going to have time to see him here. Nope.
Not meant to be. Not meant to be. So at least he holds on to that valuable rifle. That's actually pretty big for the economy here. It means that he can drop an M4 without a worry.
Yep. And we are now once more tied, this time at 5 rounds. And a very neck-and-neck battle between two teams. For those who just are tuning in, these guys actually went into overtime in their earlier game on Dust 2.
Exactly right. Aslak has that AWP once again. No targets yet. He has to actually fall back.
Osku's already pushing up middle. Once again, the same thing that Menace were doing against Public Lair.
Mm-hmm.
Him and Blaine's falling back now, though. They've already wreaked havoc in TMBG's minds. Now they can't go to the middle area because they don't know whether it's clear or not.
That's the worry, exactly. That's the worry. And we see them kind of grouping up right now. Aslak may have another opportunity here. He is boosted up, looking to put shots through that smoke. And they're really just kind of putting shots through, expecting, or hoping, rather, that Menace are on the other side. But Menace are now playing this wisely. They've burned a lot of time off the clock. They've gotten a lot of information. And now they decide to just fall back, take that info, and set up the defense to deal with things accordingly. As Osiris will find Skirk, who looked like he was pushing through underpass there.
Yep. Still a 4v5, a winnable round. Blaine's peeking aggressively in middle. Deals some damage, but takes on way more. He's down to his 36 health there, falling back towards the B side. And we see Osku are already... No, actually, never mind. It's Osiris rotating towards the B bomb side. So Menace changing spots here.
And look at this.
Aslak looks to be rotating back. That might mean they're actually hitting the A bomb side. And here's going to come Yesu and Shaker.
Exactly, and this is going to be all about Saw here in shadow. This position is so crucial. Do they check it? They do not. They lose the bomb control. Two-man, three-man advantage. Make it four. Saw continues to wreak havoc. He gets another frag. Now he's hungry. He wants a barbecue, and he's going to go for it, but Aslak manages to get two parting shots before getting overwhelmed, and that is going to be 6 rounds now for Menace on the board.
Nice shots by Aslak there, but he was just too little too late. His rotation wound up being far too late into the round, and there was just no way he was going to get in on that action unless his teammates completely cleared the site and got the bomb planted.
But now we have a pistol round coming out here from TMVG, and it seems like they want to go for a very aggressive play towards the B apartments. I mean, we shall see. They've got a man kind of scouting out at mid. Gustus putting shots through. Not going to get anything. We've lost Saw in mid, actually. That's pretty good. But now Gustus knows exactly what's up. He spotted the men out on this B site. They should be able to get the plant, but Gustus already manages to pick off one. The plant will happen. Yesu just putting it down. And now it comes down to whether TMVG can actually find any frags here. Another one would be huge if they could just get two kills. But Menace are closing in on all flanks. And they're going to run out of space here, TMVG. They're already getting closed in on Osku with a second frag.
Aslak with a nice headshot on Osku, but it's not going to be enough. Shaker just walking around the bomb site with opponents all over him. Going to take him out. They're going to get the defuse. Menace is going to get their first lead worth two rounds. That's how close the teams have been. I think it's the first two-round lead since the pistol round.
Since the pistol round, yeah.
Yeah.
Like that's. I mean, are we going to be able to see another round of overtime? That's the thing, because it was really close on Dust 2. Catching the end of that game was a real pleasure. And overtime did really go pretty heavily Menace's way, but still, it was a fine fight put up by TMVG. And TMVG continue to struggle here. Osku will find the first frag of this round, however. Entry goes his way. There is a bit of a push, and Aslak once again lays waste to underpass. He could potentially get another one, though, but he gets caught off guard. Gustus will catch him midair, and now a 3-on-3 situation. Wow, and Skirk timed out.
We see Duffman, who's playing under the Swagmaster name here, already having walked a little bit into the A bomb site. Though I think Osiris might be aware of that because he's holding that corner, just waiting for Duffman to peek.
Yeah,
I think
he knows.
I think he's going to do that, and he's going to get taken out.
The bomb is here as well, but Osiris gets the proper read. Second kill for him. Now it's all going to be down to Shaker. Last man alive walks out from pit. Osiris not getting the third kill. And, oh, somehow managing to catch
Badly
the edge with that
flash.
Shaker, he may have the opportunity here. He's going to go for the spray, got another one. He's going for it. Shaker gets all three. TMVG somehow. Menace lose control of that situation.
And that, I mean, first of all, the entire reason that round happened is because Osiris, first of all, missed the shot. And then the flash that he missed not only blinded himself, but I think it also blinded his teammate. Who was by the stairs there looking at the ground as he got shot by Shaker. And that was just a really huge mistake by Menace that really could wind up costing them this game. Now, if you take a look at the money situation here for both teams really quickly, we see Menace is very low on money. So if TMVG managed to win this round, odds are they're going to end this half with an 8-7 lead. So that mistake, that one flash, could wind up playing a crucial part in how this game plays out and who advances to the playoffs.
That's exactly. It's so painful to see that. And that's such a gut-wrenching feeling as well. You're just like, I need this flash to be perfect, and then it catches a pixel and just nothing happens. Yeah. And it's all
to be fair, there was no chance the flash was going to be perfect the way that guy was throwing it. He probably I was going to ask
unless
what he
was using
thinking.
A medium throw or a grandma throw. In which case. Oh.
TMVG gets spotted. Saw once again gets a kill. And looks like they are just going to get mowed down here. They're just way too slow. Can't get into the side. Blaine gets two kills. I think he's going to get the third too. And this is certainly going to be around. It's going to be around for Menace who get back in it. Another two-round lead for them. And it's going to be a weak force buy for TMVG.
Yeah, exactly. Going into this 15th round, there isn't a whole lot here on the board for TMVG. They get a handful of nades. And Shaker actually sacrificing a rifle so that he can get more nades. Actually, he only had 20-50, so not even that much money on Shaker. Not enough to be able to get even a Galil in armor. So this is a great situation here for Menace, but it looks like it's just going to be the straight-up YOLO rush onto A site. They're not wasting any time here, TMVG. Straight onto this site, and Saw is waiting. Osku and Osiris are, however, giving pretty good air support. Now Saw on. He's still here, but he's not getting anything. He's playing it so passively. And this is somehow now all down to Azlak, 1v4, they just get locked down, and Saw, the man I expected to actually do most of the work there, doesn't do a damn thing apart from live and get one kill and then just fade away.
Well, sometimes the most important thing when you're playing a crucial spot like that is to stay alive, those couple extra seconds that's going to stop TMVG players from looking the other way and getting those other kills. Azlak really just played this round too slow. I think he wanted to play it safe because he was the only player with a gun and armor from his team, but he really needed to be the point man getting those entries for his team to get have a chance of getting into that bomb site. That didn't happen. He played too passively, and now he's just going to pad his stats a little bit before ultimately losing. And it's going to be a 9-6 first half for Menace.
So does he even go for the fake plant there? Not really. I mean, they're going to get you in the end, Azlak. Maybe, but that's the thing, man. That's the plan from Azlak. He wants to pad his stats. What better way to pad the stats than let your teammates run in, soften up the targets a little bit, you know, with those pea shooters, and then you're walking with the AK and Kevlar. Works out great, except that this time it didn't.
Well, I mean, he got two kills.
Okay, he got two kills. What is the situation as of right now? 9-6 going into this second half now. Pistol round. Menace switching over to the T side. Now the aggressors in this new story here developing. TMVG will be having to hold here on the CT side. Man taking point is going to be Gustus rushing into CT spawn, but Shaker somehow finds the kill. And Swagmaster pops out of nowhere, gets 2-1 as well. Now we're into a 3-on-3 situation. The bomb will get planted. But they are not wasting any time at all here. TMVG rushing in. Shaker Jesu getting big kills. And now it's all down to the man of the match. Saw gets spotted in the back. Takes a lot of damage. No Kevlar for him. Way too squish. And in the end, TMVG with a near perfect retake from that situation.
Nice job by TMVG, like you said. It's retaking the site, though. They did allow Menace to get the bomb planet. So it is possible that they go for a buy here early on. Either on this round, or at least they're going to be buying on the third round, which is already going to be advantageous for them.
Yeah. I mean, we see them actually. Well, it looks like Gustus kind of wants to be, you know, the odd man out, the black sheep, because he's sticking with the P250. But the rest of them, Menace, they know where to go. CZs all day, every day. And they could probably find some damage here. They really are spread out quite a bit. Swagmaster's waiting with the Pro 90, though, and I do like this. No Kevlar on Menace means he can really wreak havoc with this SMG. Still one of the better SMGs out there.
Yep. Azlak gets the opening kill there. Playing aggressive in middle. Menace are getting ready to hit the A site. It's going to be on Shaker and Douthman to get these kills.
Looking big here for Swag. He's going to manage. He should be able to pick up one. Not sure if you heard the steps there in A apartments. But Swag, I mean, they're patiently waiting to see if they're going to find the opportunity to pick him off here. Swag is going to peek and goes for the... what? Okay,
and misses,
then.
Misses an easy shot, to say the least. Shaker and Azlak clean up. And TMVG are now within one. You hear a little laughter from a crowd there.
Nobody was watching that. Like,
I think that was deserved.
Yeah, that's what you get for buying a Pro 90. Oh, man. Okay. Well, TMVG, they lose one man, but it's a stronghold nonetheless. And Menace are now going to go for that third round by 18th round here. They got the plant in the pistol. They have the money. And they have the AKs, so this is actually a pretty decent situation now for Menace. This is their big opportunity to get on the board here in this second half. Get some of that momentum going back their way here, as TMVG have set up pretty standard tried and true so far, actually, across this map. Only man is Azlak. He's pushed out looking towards underpass, manages to turn around, look towards mid in time to pick up the kill on Osiris. And I'm curious now, does Justice find him? And yes, he does. Picks off Azlak, and now we're back into a 4-on-4. Very patient play so far from both of these teams, though. As far as the T side, the CT side, like, they really do seem to want to take their time.
Yep. None of the players just want to make big mistakes early on that are going to cost them rounds. So they rather just play it slow, take their time, and see if their opponents are going to make mistakes. 9-8, the score stands right now in favor of Menace. 4v4 situation, always advantageous for the terrorists. And it looks like Menace should be able to take this A side out once they attack it. The only defender playing in the actual site is Duffman, playing under the name of Swagmaster, and Shaker way far back. And the push is going to come now from the terrorists.
Well, Shaker managing to put up a pretty decent fight so far. Gets two kills, looks for a third one, runs out of bullets. It's going to be down to the Swag. And he's going to get one! He's still alive in the shadow, but that's not going to be good enough. Now the 2-on-1 as Saw manages to catch him on the flank. Saw still here. Yesu and CT spawn, playing patiently, waiting for his teammate to get into position, and that's going to be Skirt coming up from Connector. He manages to get right there, but as I swap away, Yesu denies, he doesn't deny the plant, but he does not let Menace walk away with this round. For now at least, we're back into a 9-9. It really does seem fated for both of these teams to never get farther than two rounds away from one another. It's just not going to happen. They are far too evenly matched at this point. Azlak with a very nice peek at mid initially, just, you know, getting a bit of breathing room, but
Azlak also opping now, so he's gonna go for an aggressive pick here in the window room. Though he doesn't look like anyone from Menace is gonna come that way. Menace getting ready to attack the A bomb site once more.
And we have a double stack on this bomb site as well. No passive holds here. In fact, Shaker could be in position to fall back to CT if he wants, but the Swagmaster himself is looking towards this A apartments. He could get a peek. This smoke could be the perfect bait. Do Menace decide to take a peek, take a risk? They're looking towards Electric right now, and they are stepping. Swagmaster knows there is people here, and he's going to get confirmation of that. Pushing up from A spawn, it is going to be Shaker trying to hold down as best he can, but it's not for long. In the meantime, Azlak with that AWP picks up two big kills, in fact. That's looking for the third. There's the flick. Going to stop the... He's not going to stop the plant in time, though. And the man... There it is. Azlak, an ace. An ace with the AWP.
And that was a nice round by him. Like I said, you know, we might see Azlak opping. He might hit some shots. Both those things happened. That was a nice round by him. 10-9 now. TMVG once again back in the lead. It's been a while since they were up. I think it was 5-4 for them the last time around. And Azlak just dominating on his side on the scoreboard.
Yeah, 24. 24 frags to his name right now. That's pretty damn healthy. And again, he goes back to a bit of a... I mean, he's getting into this position mid, but Menace really aren't giving him any targets to work with here at all. Menace, they have bought up, but they are very... I mean, they're very light on nades. They've got 3 smoke nades, no flashes, 1 HE. That's not a whole lot for an A take here. It really is going to have to come down to some great shots coming out from Menace. But the push will begin. Shaker going for the flash. Not going to get anybody, but he still managed to pick up 2, 3! The spray! And he's still alive to do massive damage. It's all going to be Osiris. Last man alive, but Shaker just wreaked havoc. What a situation from him. That spray, I thought he was done. I thought he was going to get one and then be gone. But instead, great spray control from him on that M4A1. And now Osiris is alone. No bomb for him. This is not looking good for Menace. Now it's going to be up to TMVG to get that lead, that 2-round lead. But if he can get a plant, this could be big. Not going to happen, though. Nope. Skirk will find him.
And as we look at the scoreboard now, Azlak on top of everybody else currently with 24 kills. Next player is Osiris at 19. And then the next teammate of Azlak, Shaker at 18. And the next one at 10. So like that's just really dominant on for TMVG. It's been all Aztec and Shaker. And Shaker especially had that really clutch 1v3 and then that triple kill last round. So big plays by those two. And Menace are on a CZ 75 save now.
They are. I'm curious about Skirk's position, though. The smoke is down. They have some flashes and they have some smoke, however. So I'm looking to see because it looks like Menace. They got an idea and they're looking through this. They're looking through the smoke as well. There's the punish. Skirk, he's wised up. He knows what's happening. There's his smoke. That's not going to do a damn thing, though. Great flash, and that's an entry there onto the B site. This who picks one out of the sky, though. He thinks he's hunting, but in the end, it is still a 3-on-3 situation and a plant for Menace. Oh, Aslak is now coming to play with the AWP, though. Misses that shot. Good little peek there to get confirmation, but he's got support now with the rifle. Shaker's going to push up, pick up one. Aslak looking for the last one at the back of the site, but he's not going to get it. And in the end, TMVG will extend their lead now, a 3-round lead. It's like the first time so far in this series that a team has gotten this far ahead. Menace now on the ropes, but a good eco nonetheless. Two kills and a plant. I think that they can consider their work pretty well done here.
Yeah, it was a good save round. But at the same time, it's the biggest lead of the game now. 3 rounds for TMVG. 12-9, and they're kind of getting away now. Aslak with 10K still in the bank.
Yeah.
So a bunch of money for the counter-terrorists as well.
And that's bad news. That's bad news when it's when the AWPer has that kind of money, because that means he's basically going to be able to buy that off 3 rounds running if he wants, or 2 rounds running at least.
And that also means he can take some risks if he wants to.
Exactly. So now, I mean, are they going to be able to handle Aslak? He just seems to be tearing away in this match so far. Smoke going down there from Gustus. That's going to actually go straight up into mid window here. Boop. And that's going to give a little bit of control here for Menace actually out mid. If Aslak was, you know, going into that position, as he was, I mean, look at him. He's still waiting here in window. He still wants to find someone to use this AWP on.
TMVG with two defenders in the B bomb site right now. Skirk in a very good spot to toss this molly just as soon as Menace start moving in. But it is clear Menace are going to be attacking the B bomb site this round. And this is where the push comes with all those nades just running in. The molly is going to go into the B hallway right now. And that's going to make it tough for Menace to get in.
Yeah, good start there from Skirk already, taking a massive damage. Osku is going to manage to not get out of the site. He burns to death, gets caught on an angle, and now Swagmaster is looking for the final frag. It is going to be Gustus. Not sure if he heard the step, but he's looking for the rotation now to cut them off. Manages to get the drop on one, turns away, and here's the second man. Not going to get the kill, though. And Gustus, I mean, well, at this point, too much video games. They can just run around and do whatever they please. They can hunt this guy down. They've got him boxed in. He has nowhere to go. He just has to hope that they give him a target.
And at this point, it does make sense to hunt him down, but they probably want to wait until his time runs out, because at that point, he wouldn't get any money. Well, Aslak got a little frag hungry there.
Yeah, exactly.
With 27 kills. It actually would have made more sense to just wait until the last second. Once time runs out, all just jump down and just make sure you kill him, because he would have had no money at all for the next round. Mm-hmm. Now Menace are going to be in a buy round, but they're down 4 rounds. Osiris opting to buy an AWP, trying to battle Aslak in some 1v1 battles. See how that plays out. Aslak once again gone for the aggressive peak here, whereas Osiris holding in the A apartments.
Yeah, but they've been pretty consistent. Oh, Blaze will hit the headshot on Aslak out at mid. Was not expecting that. And this sets it up interestingly here. Now Menace have got control of mid. They spot out a manor close to Electric on stairs as well. They go for the boost up in, and that is going to be Blaine's continuing to press forward. Osiris will find the frag, however, from A Apartments. And this is the thing. Bringing this A Apartments just opens everything up with no smoke here to stop it. He gets caught by the Swagmaster himself, though. Swag still going for the shots, but he's not going to land it. And in the end, it will be Skirk, last man alive here for TMVG, rotating over from the B site. Tries to put a stop to that plan and actually does succeed in delaying it, but it's not going to be good enough here, 1v4. Granted, they've got the money to go for the funny plays here. If he can manage to pick up another rifle, that would be huge, but Gustus will end him.
Yep. That's going to make it 10-13. Now Menace still 3 rounds down, but importantly, 4 of their players survived the previous round, which means they now have a bunch of money saved up. And even if they were to lose this round, they could still afford a buy.
Well, it's like the balance of nature, you know, has been wronged here, because now, I mean, 3 rounds in a row, or rather 3 rounds, believe we can see it. Yeah, quite a few rounds, in fact, for the CT side here to close that gap and bring it back. So that was actually quite a performance here from TMVG so far. First round now that Menace have managed to put on the board here in their T half. And we will see. I mean, are TMVG going to be able to bounce right back? Because that would not be very good for Menace if they lost the momentum that they've managed to generate now. Osiris taking the majority of that damage, but there is Swagmaster. Flash burning. He's going to get out just in the nick of time. Shaker is actually the one doing a lot of the damage here. He will get overrun, but Swagmaster from the site trying to put shots in. Not going to get anything. Spots it out now, but it's going to be down to Yesu. He gets one. Can't get two. And now we look to Azlak. Azlak, who so far has dominated outright. No nades. One smoke and one flash, but no HEs here for TMVG. I'm sure they would love to have an HE to just chuck into that back corner right there. Pick off the man who's holding on around that angle, who is Osku. But Azlak has spotted a man. Goes for the flick, not going to get it. And now he has to kind of just go for it. They've run out of time. Swaps out for the M4. Only 7 bullets left, and he is not going to manage this. He will get caught. And in the end, it will just be Skurk backing off trying to save this gun.
It's an odd move for Azlak to just go for it all by himself, try to play the hero. I mean, Skurk even fell back instantly. There was no way he was going to get that. He probably should have just saved that up and had more money going forward, because now too much video games have been put into a situation where if they were to lose this round as well, all of a sudden they would have to save, and that would then most likely equalize the score at 13, which would give all the advantage to Menace. It's a very close game once again between these two teams.
Right now, I mean, between these two teams, I mean, Osiris, they're kind of just, it's the standoff again at mid. Nobody on the A side this time around for Menace. They're putting all their focus towards mid, up in B apartments, really expecting TMVG to kind of give them a taste of their own medicine with aggressive pushes up mid and underpass, and TMVG aren't having any of that. They've gone back to a very bread and butter hold, in fact, 3 on A, 2 on B, not really giving any kind of attention to mid, and Azlak is going to be the only man here playing in a bit of a Pasha spot, in fact. And this is a spot that Pasha excels at, looking towards CPL, kind of dancing around here, looking through a connector with an AWP like this. Interesting to see Azlak having a similar style, but again, it seems like this is actually going to work out for TMVG. Menace deciding to go for an A pick, or pardon me, an A play at the end. What do you make of this decision so far, Lurpus? I mean, is this the right call to go for? They have had some success on this site.
I mean, the way their last B attack went, there really is no way they can attack B the same way. They would have to have some fake to throw, which they haven't done so far in 2 games, so they probably don't have that in their arsenal. It's going to be a dangerous molly there, but Shaker is going to escape untouched. Duffman gets the first kill, gets 2 kills there. Shaker gets a kill, make that a double. And too much video games to shut the push down. Saw the star player of Menace so far this tournament left in a 1v3.
He's got no time as well, but he's got his smoke up, and he's going to get the plant barely in the nick of time there. 2 guys pushing up from CT spawn, however, and he gets overwhelmed instantly. Saw not able to do anything really in that situation. Had they been like 2 in connector, 1 in CT, maybe he catches that guy in CT off guard. That's probably what he was thinking at the end, but he just got caught between a rock and a hard place there.
Yep. I mean, there's just no way, really, for Saw to clutch that round with as little time as there was left on a clock, because too much video games could just rush him from every direction, and they were already close enough that he really couldn't set up any better either. So 14-11, and now Menace have their backs against the wall. I mean, they did force overtime in the first game after facing elimination at 15-13, but let's see if they can do it here.
I'm looking to see if Azlak is actually going to manage to pick up the bomb carrier right here. It's a scary situation. Smoke going to go down. Nade to follow. Good damage there to Azlak. That's going to ring his bell. And Azlak expecting the boost up. He could get rewarded here so big.
He knows it's going to come, and it did. But I don't think he realizes Blaine's is already up there. This could be dangerous for him if he's not cautious about it.
He's really expecting. I mean, now he's going to jump forward. Now Blaine knows there's a man around this corner, and Azlak just scopes up as Blaine comes around the corner. He did not spot the leg there. He's looking towards underpass. He's playing as if he has no idea, and Blaine's gets rewarded for his patience. Playing it so cool. It's going to be Swagmaster now looking towards that A apartment. Not going to find the kill, though. Augustus will get him first. Blaine's, everybody on Menace racking up kills at this point. Blaine's with 2, but still in, I mean, a dominant round out of TMVG in the last one. And this time around, Menace just turned it on its head. A perfect round for them.
Yep. Nice play by Menace. And once again, I mean, I feel like a broken record saying this all the time, but it was a big thing for them to win that round so easily too, because it majorly affects the money situation. First of all, they get a bunch of money saved, and too much video games are in a save round now. Should make it 14-13, and it's still very much anyone's game.
That's the crucial part. Osiris is going to be looking towards the BS, but it's going to be the man ass like himself. Manages to pick up a gun. Is he going to be able to get out of here in time? And they're not really pursuing him fast enough, and he does manage to make it out with not with an AWP, but with an AK. That's plenty of firepower for him to put to use here. In the meantime, we've got a push coming out through the B apartments. Osiris leading the way, but there are men on short. Are they going to be able to make it out here in time? Bit of fuzzy movement there, but he's still going to spot one. Goes for the shot. Not going to get it.
Aslak once again gets a kill. Aslak
getting two.
No, it's three for him already.
This is huge.
Just a monster, but peaks too much. Our Shaker and Yesu are going to be able to bring this one home. I don't know. They only have pistols.
They only have pistols, and it's not going to be enough.
That's not going to happen. Oscar gets four kills. That tops Aslak's triple. 14-13.
This is enough for them to force up as well if they want TMVG. Aslak, because of those kills, manages to get more than enough to get that AWP. The rest of his teammates all floating around the 4K mark, so they will have enough to be able to get some M4s. A FAMAS, but still, this is enough gear for them to have an impact here. This is enough gear for them to shut Menace down. Wondering where Menace exactly decided to go. Again, very patient play coming out here from Menace. Not really willing to take a fight anywhere at all. It's going to be Aslak, however, looking towards top mid. Takes the shot and whiffs it. Osku will live to fight another day, and Osku actually, no fear, deciding to get right up in Aslak's face, again with the nades. Man, they're making it look the same, though, Menace, and this time, not wasting any time at all, it's Blaine's. Once again, they're going for the same play that was so successful the last round. Looking to see Osiris, if he's actually going to manage to find the angle here. He looks away, the timing is everything, and he misses his big opportunity. Makes a bit of a jump there as well. And I think that alerted the A defense as to one man at least being up in the apartments. Skirk's position, though, this is Cheek. He's in a fantastic position. If he decides to back off, and he will decide to back off, they seem like they know exactly where he is. They're already putting shots on him, but Yesu manages to find the man. That was Blaine's trying to go for the wraparound. Now Skirk holding down Mouse 1. Good spray from him. Two kills. Saw now trying to take point. Alive on the balcony, looking for the shot, but he's not going to get it. Skirt gets yet another one, and Skirt going for the final one, not going to make it. But still, that puts TMVG on their 15th round, one round away from taking second seed in this group.
That was a nice triple and an assist for Skirt, and there's something to be said about having a little bit of routine of playing against international teams and actually having played with the Finnish top team. You could tell he just wasn't peeking like an idiot, because a lot of the players would have just gone for the frag movie clip there right after the third kill, whereas he just sat patiently in the side and allowed for his teammates to rotate.
And that was perfect, exactly. Him staying alive is the most important thing as well, because then we already saw it. You know, Saul has to pause on that balcony. That exposes him to shots from Kitchen. And, well, Skirk's teammates step in on that. Swagmaster actually getting a little bit jumpy there, taking shots at his teammate himself, and now it just falls apart. Aslak with the AWP tries to put a shot through smoke. Two of them, not going to get anything out of it, and in fact takes a whole lot of damage to the face, drops down to 17. And now, this may very well have to play out. It is going to be a save. TMVG too far behind in this sort of thing, it looks like. It looks like they really want to put it down to the 30th round, and we may get yet another overtime between these two teams. That's how even they are.
Yeah, I mean, that would be a nice way to end this. Definitely what this match deserves.
I love how Aslak's AWP has, you know, the burn them all sticker on it as well. That's really fitting. That's perfect.
So Aslak is going to be able to drop a weapon, and then Skirk or Yesu are going to only be able to drop a FAMAS, so near perfect equipment for TMVG. And we'll see. I mean, they already had this chance in the earlier game. They had a chance to put it away before going into overtime. They couldn't do it. Now they get another chance. Do they have enough killer instinct on him, or in him rather? Put this away? Are we going to go into another overtime?
That's the thing. There is gear here, and we're following Aslak now, looking towards mid. This would be huge if he can get the first pick. Looks away at the last second. He's getting two opportunities there, and he just can't get it done. Wisely decides to back off, however. Not going to open it up again. But yet again, look, it's developing into the play. Blaine's this time is carrying the bomb, and they decide to change it up. They're going for the B play yet again, wrapping around through apartments on short. Everybody here for Menace, and Skirk, again, he has to play big, but it's not meant to be. Blaine's finds him, cuts him out, and now it is down to Yesu, who gets two big frags, still alive in Kitchen as well. And this is a huge opportunity now for him to turn it around. He gives his team the man advantage, closing in on this site. One man is going to be at the plant, but there is still one. Osku looking towards the cross, spots him on the edge, goes for the spray.
Yesu with a triple.
But Yesu is too big. The nade not going to be enough, but it's a two-on-two now. They get caught out the flank. The man on short comes in at the perfect time. Yesu going to peek at bench, not going to find it. Madly spraying, but nothing comes. And now it's Azlak with the 5-7. Caught in a crossfire, no hope. And this should be 15-15, unless Azlak can do something magical. There's the first shot, but he's running out of time. He has to go for the defuse, and it's not meant to be. He can't do it. There's no time left. And it is going to be overtime again. Menace and TMVG. It's just meant to be. 30 rounds. That's how it has to go, Lurpus.
It has to go. Two overtime battles between these two teams. Only this one is going to be for all the marbles.
That's perfect. This is the lower bracket match now. Or lower bracket. Yeah, I guess that works. Lower bracket match of Group A. The winner of this team will move on into the playoffs on Saturday as a second seed of Group A. As far as we're concerned, this has been fantastic. And on Dust2, same sort of thing. Again, so close between these two teams on their first match of the day. 30 rounds. And then in the end, Menace managed to take the win. So we'll have to see if they can repeat history. But we are not wasting any time. Oh, actually, we are. Never mind.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Just the right amount. Hopefully we can get underway here quickly without a lengthy break. Looks like the overtime config was just loaded. So it'll probably be, game will probably be going live just any second here. And
everybody's ready. Everybody's ready.
You know, an even more fitting ending than overtime would have probably been an Azlak clutch at the end with the way he was playing, because he was carrying that team.
He was really close.
Take Azlak off that team, they're probably an eight-round team against Menace here.
Unfortunately, the score has reset, but I wouldn't be surprised if he was close to dropping a 30 bomb if he hadn't already dropped a
30 bomb. Yeah, 33 and frags. 18. So it was plus 15 in an overtime game. That's pretty sick.
That's a sick performance. You're right. Yeah. And opping as well for the majority of that time.
And he also had that ace. That was pretty important for TMVG to get that lead. And we're actually live now with overtime, so we're going to go back into the game.
We're back into it, guys, and we already follow Azlak changing up his position, going back into the window. He's going to have the opportunity, and this time around, we talked him up too much. Misses the shot that he should very well have got, and now Menace are going to be closing in on this A site. The bomb, however, making its way out through pit. There's going to be a man, Shaker, on A site, looking to try and shut down the push, but it's not meant to be. Swagmaster is gone, Shaker is gone now, and it is going to be down to Azlak with this AWP. Finds a shot and can't land it. Menace just walked through the defense, no problem at all. Yesu does deny the plant, and that was very finely done. But there's so much work left for Skirk to do. 1v3 and down to 40 HP.
Down to 7, he's going to be saving this gun.
He has to.
I mean, yeah, Menace just walked through TMVG in the sense that it was really easy. It took almost looked like it took no effort, but really they ran through TMVG because that was a quick round. And you could tell after playing the entire half slowly, Azlak's team simply were not ready whatsoever
for the aggression.
Yeah,
you gotta like that as well. Menace, you know, they just decide to change up the pace going into the overtime. It's just no time wasted. Really looking to catch TMVG on the back foot, and this is the real problem here right now is because this is MR3 and 10k starting money. So TMVG at this point have to be really worried. As the CT side, you definitely want to pick up that first round to give you a little bit of security as far as the money is concerned. Right now, if TMVG, Skirk saves a gun, which is big, but if TMVG lose this round, they're going to be forcing it up and buying pistols, armor, whatever they can in the last round. So this could be a big opportunity here for Menace. Just to remind you all, it's the first of four rounds here in this overtime. So Menace, all they need is another three rounds, and they are through a second seed. So there's a big opportunity here, and they're off to a good start. But now we have to see if TMVG can turn it around. We're going to be looking towards Azlak, of course, putting that AWP to work. But there is a very aggressive push so far coming out through mid for Menace. Again, just the fight to get control, to give options to that T side. Oh, I like the cheek. But again, it's going to be Blaine's.
Yep, and look at Blaine's once again out there. Azlak this time smartly moves out. But that's going to open up more room for Blaine's to wreak havoc in.
Well, the thing is, does Shaker have any idea that Blaine's is here? He's checking this time. He really is checking this time.
But all it takes is a couple steps too many, too far out, and Blaine's is going to have a huge advantage to get this kill. He's waiting in a really good corner. Just depends who makes the first move.
Shaker doesn't know. And Shaker's going to get caught. And now Swagmaster strikes back. Two quick kills back TMVG's way. But they need to line it up, and they are not going to get it.
Aslak gets taken out by Osiris. That was the kill. That's going to allow Menace to get into the site freely and get the bomb planted. And it's going to make it damn hard for TMVG to retake. Blaine's with a second kill around. Takes out Skirk. Osiris gets his second. And it really does look like TMVG are just letting this one slip away.
There's still 7 grand on Skirk. There's still 7,000 thanks to him saving that rifle. But Aslak, oh, Skirk is going to pick up the AWP. Aslak goes for a scout buy instead. He's able to get Kevlar on top of that because of how, because the price of the scout has been reduced. But I was really expecting Skirk to drop a gun there with 7K in the bank. As far as things are concerned, however, TMVG, they're down 2-0, first half of overtime. And as we see, they're able to find an AWP, which could actually catch Menace off guard. Menace might not be expecting this. But still, this is going to be a very tough round for them to hold on to, especially with how well Menace have been playing so far in this half. I mean, they just looked dominant.
Yep. And really, I mean, TMVG just must win this final round of the half. Aslak with a scout now. Oddly enough, Skirk has an AWP. So that's a questionable choice, in my opinion. I would have probably swapped those two around.
That's why I'm surprised. But then I'm also surprised that Skirk didn't decide to just drop a Famase for another teammate, because he had 7 grand in the bank. You know, if Aslak buys the scout, at that point you're just like, okay, Skirk, drop a Famase, get an M4, and you have an extra guy with a rifle. I guess that's the faith that they have in the CZ75 on Shaker, and the 5.7. But a lot of information coming in here right now. Aslak scouted up. Does he get the shot? Goes for the flick. Doesn't land it. Misses his opportunity to do big here, but it's going to be Skirk who does not, however, pick up. He picks up one frag, but Gustus is going to strike back and pick up Aslak. Now Skirk going for a leaping shot. Not going to get it. Nothing coming of that. And now it comes down to whether they can wait for the smoke, but Shaker with the flank. He gets one. Instantly shut down, though, but that did cause a bit of a stir here on the T side, forcing a bit of an awkward situation.
The Skirk is just so far back and so passive. They don't have to... They don't have... Oh, Yesu has a defuse kit, but that's the only one. And there's just no way for TMVG to win this round. I mean, this is where you can tell that they're still a mixed team. Because they... What? Skirt's going to save this weapon? Last round?
Last round.
I mean, that was just poor play by TMVG. I mean, there's no situation on Earth where you don't give Aslak that up with the way he's been playing. He's been on fire this entire game. Your team can afford one up, and you give it to a player who never ups. What?
Yeah.
Is this a matchmaking game, or are these guys playing for their life in this tournament? If I wouldn't know any better, I would put money on the former.
It seems like it. I mean, right now, that's why I was so surprised at the very beginning.
That's just insanity.
Look at Saul, though. Saul, he has no mercy. Saul just pushes straight up to the top of mid, gets another kill. Saw is just crushing right now. Two guys, and now it is Skirk. The GG's already getting called. Skirk, no faith from his teammates.
There's a sarcastic tone to that capitalization.
Yeah, I think so.
In Aslak's GG. He's not happy.
You know him right now. You know, you can hear his voice. Yeah, GG. Where is it, though? I mean, Skirk.
What a disappointing way for TMVG to go out of this tournament. They had two chances to beat Menace, and both times they had, I think it was 15-13 in both games. Both times they let it get to overtime, and both times they lost in overtime. So that's just devastating for them.
Despite, great performances from Aslak.
Yeah, and even Shaker had a really good game too. So for those two, it has to be extra depressing going out of this tournament this early.
But you have to give props to Menace as well. Just dominant. Normal time.
Menace showed their ability to adjust. They made the right adjustments both times going into overtime. And that was good job by them.
Exactly. They made the right calls in the end, and we could tell the experience coming to the fore there. But TMVG, Skirk, Aslak, they will be knocked out. The Swagmaster is no longer here.